kind of appreciation video to Philippines government for what they did to not just their citizens, but also the foreigners living in their country. In Tagalog, Miami, Miami, Miami.
Miami. Miami po. 6 points, I just want to say.
Miami, 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 salamat po. Po. Hi lovelies, welcome back again to my channel. If you are new here, if it is your first time of coming across this channel, my name is Ruth, final-year nursing student currently living and studying in the Philippines, and you are welcome to Nurse Ruth Nook. For my old subscribers, my Mangies, thank you so much for your support and for always clicking in. I appreciate you all. If you are yet to subscribe to this channel, please do well to hit the red subscribe button now and like the video, comment, leave down in the comment section the kind of videos you would like to always see. Please do well to turn on the post notification bell when you subscribe and share the video. So lovelies, in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you all my personal experience and observations during the pandemic, the lockdown here in the Philippines. If you are interested in finding out my observations, then you definitely need to keep on watching. Welcome back guys. Like I said in the intro, I will share with you my personal experience and observations during the lockdown here in the Philippines as a foreigner. Number one point, guys, during the lockdown in the Philippines, would you believe that Philippines government shared foodstuff to its citizens? Yes. They shared foodstuff to their citizens, not just the citizens of the Philippines, but also extended it to foreigners living in their country without segregation, without minding, these people are citizens, these are not citizens, so it's meant for the citizens. No, they extended their love, they extended that to even foreigners. I was surprised one day when my friend called me to ask me if I got anything from the barangay officials. Barangay here in Philippines is like saying local governments in Nigeria. Yes, the apartment, and they will come knocking at your door. The next thing is they will drop the foodstuff for you. In it, you have rice, raw rice, you have spaghetti, you have sachet tomato and lots more in the bag that would last one for some time. And this was not done once, not twice, not thrice. They did this over and over again all through the lockdown, knowing that people were asked to stay indoors. They did well to share food to their citizens, and not just their citizens, to also foreigners living in their country. A big thank you to Philippine government for being there for their citizens, for being there for not just their citizens, also foreigners living in their country, reaching out to them by sharing those foodstuff. Point number two of my experience here during the lockdown in the Philippines. Guys, would you also believe that Filipino government shared money to its citizens? Yes, they shared money to their citizens, not just once, not twice. The money they shared to citizens, they shared it to those they know could not really afford 3 square, like those, I don't want to use the word low class. Say big kudos to Philippines government. Do you know what it means to share money to more than how many thousands or even millions of people in a country? That happened here in the Philippines. The government shared food to their citizens. They also shared money to their citizens. That's a big chorus to Philippines government. Point number three. Number three of my experience here during the lockdown pandemic 2020 here in the Philippines. My school also shared things to their students. Yes. Apart from my school, different schools in Philippines reached out to their students during the pandemic. I was surprised when I got a mail from my school requesting that I reply. And also, other students also got the same message requesting that we reply or respond to the email if we need any provision. Just indicate by replying the messages. Then obviously there was no school. School was not on session during the lockdown, so there was no school. But I was surprised that they also remembered their students, they remembered us, and they reached out to us. Appreciation to Philippines, to my school, and to all other schools in the Philippines that reached out to their students. Please keep up the good work. Number four, if you are going out, you must go out with your face mask. If you go out without your face mask, if you are caught by the police, you will be arrested and you have a very big fine to pay for it. The curfew time was observed. The social distancing was observed. The way the Filipinos coordinated themselves and cooperated with their government during the lockdown is something commendable. If someone wants to go to the market during the lockdown, you don't go in at once. No, there will always be queue, and you move into the market batch by batch. They made sure to not overpopulate the places like markets and malls. If you want to go to the mall, you stay in the queue observing social distancing. This batch will go first. When they come out, and you have limited time you spend in the mall, when you come out, the other batch would go. And there was cooperation, there was coordination, there was no rushing, there was nothing like doing things the way you want to do it. No, you have to follow the rules and regulation, and you have to make sure everyone made sure to keep to those rules and regulation, both the citizens and the foreigners. That is something commendable. The government did their bit, and the people on their own part also reciprocated. They also did their own part. A country as Philippines can be this coordinated. Wow. It is a big kudos to Filipinos. It is a big kudos to Philippine government. They really did well during the lockdown. That's my own personal observation and experience here in the Philippines. Point number five, guys, the last but not the least. During the lockdown, I observed that people were reaching out to their neighbors, to their loved ones, not just their loved ones, reaching out to people. I do not want to use the word the rich and the poor, no. Let me just say those that could afford 3 square meals a day comfortably reached out to those ones they know could not afford it. They're sharing out things to them, giving them things. My classmates that reached out to me asking, Ruth, how are you doing? How are you faring? Hope you are fine. You take care. Indeed, this country, they really express love amongst themselves. And the love is something so commendable. Thank you so much, lovelies, for being here with me, for watching this video up until now. And I want to seize this opportunity to say a very big shout out to you all, Filipinos and Filipinas, including your government, my school. Thank you to Philippine government for what they did to not just their citizens, but also the foreigners living in their country. And thank you to my school for not just abandoning us during the lockdown, but for reaching out to us, the students, to make sure that we are fine. And for the things you gave to us, I want to say a very big thank you to my school, my classmates who reached out to make sure that Ruth, hope you're fine, hope you're coping well. I thank you so much, guys. At this point, I want to say in Tagalog, Mayami, Mayami,
Mayami,
Mayami.
So at this point, I just want to say,
Marami, 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 Salamat much for your love. Thank you so much for your care. No wonder they say, and I have experienced it living here in Philippines, Filipinos, they are loving, they are caring, they are homely, they are accommodating. They are so peaceful and so good. They are so loving people. So they have watched me up until now, and you are yet to subscribe to this channel. What are you waiting for? Please do well to hit the red subscribe button now so you join this amazing channel. Turn on the bell notification so you'll be the first to be notified anytime as Ruth upload a new video. Like the video, leave your comments down in the comment section. If you have any suggestion of the kind of video you want to see me put up next, or you want to be seen on this channel, please do well to leave it in the comment section, or you can message me on my Instagram handle. I'll attend to read, share this video. Until I come your way next time, keep safe, stay safe. God bless you all. Bye-bye.